Hi everyone and welcome back to the fourth project of my Christmas Art Journal series. The inspiration for today comes from this adorable die. This is one by Sizik and it gives you this little guy who is skating. You will get a big size of this guy and along with trees, so you can build up a little scene really quick and easily. Now this guy has a twin brother from last year and probably you remember this project that I did. It was created on a loose 6x6 paper, which allows me to easily frame it on a shadow box, just like I did with the last project. So you can follow the same idea for the new guy and create something similar. But today I'm going for a little scene and I will be working on my Dilutions mini art journal. I'm going to work with distress paint on the background, which is actually acrylic paint, so you can use any two shades of blue that you have. I do have this for ages. And the dabbers at the top are completely dry, so they don't work like that. There are new tops available for these bottles, but I don't bother. I just unscrew the top and use it directly on my glass mat. The two colors that I finally decided to go with for my background are Chipped Sapphire, which is the darker shade, and Salty Ocean, just to add a touch of highlights here and there. I'm using a soft brush, which is slightly damp, and I'm going to apply the color directly on the page. I haven't prepped the page with anything, no gesso, I'm just working directly on there. And once I apply the first darker layer, then I'm going to dab my brush without even cleaning it in water. And I'm going to go over the darker shade just to add some highlights here and there. This is a really basic way to create a background, to get rid of that blank area. Now, if you follow my videos, you know that I am incapable of leaving white space, so I have to cover up everything. And although the background doesn't look so interesting at the moment, there are so many different techniques that you can work with to make this look more interesting. So, for example, you can spray on top. I'm using a darker shade of blue that I found in my sprays, and this is actually Gloss Spray. The color is Night by Dina Weekly. I love the fact that this spray is going to dry permanent, and this is actually acrylic paint in a form of a spray. I'm not being very neat, and I don't want to have rectangles like up there. That's why I'm using a paper towel to wipe it off and make it look more organic. I didn't like the outcome. And then finally I'm going to use the stencil, and you can see that I have paint on top of it. I'm going to use it upside down and clean it directly on top of my page, so I don't lose any of that paint, and I do add some interest on other areas of the page. And since I cannot stay away from splatters, I'm going to use the same paint and add a few here and there. Everything I used up to now on my page dries permanent. And so first I did use my acrylic paints, then I did use the spray that dries permanent. Now I'm going over to a jet black ink, and this is archival ink, which means that it is also permanent. And I'm darkening up the top of my page. I want to have kind of a sky there, and I want that to be darker at the top. I looked through my stash and I found this rubber stamp that has lots and lots of sayings that have to do with Christmas. So it has Happy Holidays, Merry Christmas and things like that. I'm going to ink it up with Versamark ink and I'm going to stamp in different areas, mainly on the top corners, making sure that nothing is going to look as a perfect rectangle, so that I can apply some white embossing powder on top. This is going to add more interest on my background, and if you find something looks too perfect, then you can use a dry brush and clear some of that embossing powder here and there. I'm going to use my heat gun to melt the embossing powder, and I absolutely love how that white stands out against the dark background. And I did repeat the same process for the other side as well. And if you follow my videos, you already know what's the next step. So I'm going to put my art journal inside the box and I'm going to go with splashes. This time I'm using this brush that makes sure that all the splatters are going to be nice and fine. I'm using watered-down gesso for that. And this is why it was really important for me to use permanent mediums on my background. So I used acrylic paint, distress paint, which is permanent. Then on top I did use the Dina Weekly spray, permanent again. And then on top I just did some heat embossing. This means that whatever I add on top, like these splashes, are not going to react with the color underneath. So they are going to stay nice and vibrant and super white, just like they are now. Here is a close-up look on how the background is looking at the moment. I'm going to leave this aside to dry and let's work on the focal points. So I'm going to die cut all the bits and pieces from the set. I'm cutting out lots of trees. For that I use mixed media paper. You can see that it is kind of off-white, so you can tell. I am also going to cut out all the snow that I need from white cardstock, as well as the little guy out of black cardstock, but you will see that later on I'm going to change my mind for this guy. Now, looking through my stash, I found this die, which is absolutely adorable. I did use it in a previous project, last year probably, and I'm going to use it on this page as well. So I get that Santa with the reindeers, which I'm going to die cut from black cardstock as well. So just like I promised from the beginning in this Christmas Art Journal series, I am going to use a new product but combine things from previous releases, from older years, things that I already have in my stash. So here I'm going to color the trees. For that I'm using the new color. This is Rustic Wilderness, and I did use that on the previous video that I did, and I absolutely love the results. So I am repeating the exact same process, just spraying all over the trees, making sure that I end up having some lighter and darker areas. Now, if you notice closely, I do have some bleeding through from the back of the box. I do use this box for spraying a lot. And if you notice, my trees do pick up a little bit of brown and red from previous distress oxides, just because they are not permanent and they do react and activate whenever you spray with water. But this really wasn't a problem. I think that they really added more character and interest on my trees, so they didn't end up having just a flat layer of green color. Now I'm putting the trees together, just sticking the tree trunks at the center. I did cut out all the tree trunks from brown cardstock, and now I have a bunch of die-cut snow that I'm going to stick on top of the trees. When these dies die cut the trees, they are going to give you some scoring lines where you will be able to see which snow goes to where. And I'm not gonna lie, I did start really neat making sure that I follow these lines, but in the process I thought I won't bother at all. So I will just stick a bunch of snow here and there just to make sure that I cover up all the branches, and I think the finished look was better since no tree is identical with another. I want to create some snowbanks for the bottom of my page. For that I'm just using white thin cardstock, and I'm going to tear off some strips so that I can stick one on top of the other. I am going to stick everything completely flat on my page since this is a book and I don't want to add too much of dimension. But if you are making a similar project on a canvas or on a loose paper for decorating your house or for putting it inside a shadow box, then you can go as dimensional as you like. So here you can see I did stack down a couple of snowbanks, but they are completely flat one on top of the other. However, I get that tiered edge that really adds something to the page. So I am going to stick down the trees. Now, if you notice, this is white on white, so to help it stand out against each other, I'm going to ink up the edge, and this is a very light shade of blue. Actually, this is Speckletech, I believe. I'm just inking up the edges, just a touch, not too much, and you will see that now it's going to stand out. And I did repeat the same process on the other side, making sure that I have a snowbank and a couple of trees there as well. Now I'm going to create a full moon. I did die cut a circle out of my mixed media paper, so you can see this is already off-white. I'm going to add some splashes. That was distress oxide spray and the color was wild honey. With my brush I'm going to spread them out. I'm also going to spray water on top. I will dab it with my paper roll to pick up any excess color, and now I'm going to call my moon done. The main reason I decided to go with the moon for my layout was to help my Santa stand out. So my Santa is actually cut out from black cardstock, and if I place black cardstock on top of a dark navy background, it's not going to show at all. However, by placing the moon and the Santa on top, you can perfectly see the silhouette. I'm also going to help him by adding a little bit of inking on the top, so as if it is lighted from the moon. And later on I'm going to use my white gel pen, and you will see a big difference there as well. When I have a big element that has to go on both pages, I like to cut it in half so that I can stick one on one page and then just put them together like a puzzle on the other page. This way you make sure that when you open and close the book, they are going to stay put. Now it's time to stick the little elf on the page, but you do see that it doesn't stand out against the dark background. Of course, you can do the little tips and tricks that I show you for the Santa, so you can ink up the edges and use a gel pen later on. However, I'm going to take it a step further, that you can easily add color on a silhouette like this one. So I did die cut it from green, red, white, as well as off-white cardstock that would look like flesh. And I did cut it out one more time from silver. So I'm going to follow some of those lines and cut out bits and pieces so that I can do some paper piecing. So here you can see I cut out the hat, and I will do the same thing for the rest of the parts. So you can see here I'm cutting out bits and pieces that I can use to decorate the hat with white areas. I'm going to use the green for his pants. So I do separate the legs as well. And once I have all the pieces ready, I'm going to do a little bit of paper piecing, sticking all those colorful ones on top of the black one. And here is the little guy all ready to go. If you want to add even more details like I do, and I can never stop adding details, you can use some pattern paper to create a scarf. So I am inking up the edges just to add some shadows here and there, not too much. And then I'm going to use this pattern paper with the plaid on top, and I'm going to die cut it a couple of times so that I can create a couple of different pieces for the scarf, so that I can stick one on top of the other. But again, remember, you don't have to go through the whole process of adding all those details on him. You can just stick him on top of the page by being completely black and adding highlights with your gel pen or with a little bit of inking. However, this is me. I'm having fun here, and I absolutely love playing with paper, and especially paper piecing. That's why I had to go all the way. I'm going to stick him down. Again, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. And although he does have a lot of layers, he's not bulky at all since I didn't use any foam tape, so I'm not adding any bulk on my book. A really important step, especially for the black silhouettes, is to add the highlighting as if they are lighted by the moon. This is going to help them stand out against the background, and they really make a big difference. Make sure to check the photos at the end of the video. And as you already know, I absolutely love that look, so I'm going to add some highlights here and there, not only on the Santa, but also on the tree trunks, on the branches, as well as on my little elf. The pen I'm using for the highlights is the Jelly Roll 08, you will find it linked down below. Also, the highlight lines that I'm adding are really sketchy, and I'm not paying any attention on where the source of light is. I'm just adding highlights here and there, wherever I feel like it. I'm also going to bring in a fine liner in black, and I'm going to add some sketchy black lines on his scarf. This is going to help add some shadow there, and it's going to help it stand out. And this is where I don't know where to stop when it comes to details. So here I'm going to add another piece of that pattern paper at the top of his scarf, just to make it fluffier and coming more up on his face. This way I will be able to add just a couple of dots for his eyes without having to draw his nose and mouth. And finally, it's time to add the coat. For that I went with It's All Fun and Games. Until Santa checks the naughty list. I think that was really hilarious, and I think it's the perfect quote for this page, with that little elf having fun in the snow while Santa is coming over. By the way, lately I like to use my label maker to print out my quotes. And as a finishing touch, I'm adding my gel pen to add some sketchy lines around my stickers. So that was the project for today. I hope that you had fun and that you got inspired. Just like always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I used down below in the description area. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you all so much for spending some time with me today, and I'll see you all next time.